It's the long-awaited Valentine's Day week, and I have three different bakes that I want to do. Two are from the Septu dessert, one is from baking yesterday, but I'm going to add a supplementary art on top. And the first one is the Predator cookies from the Septu dessert. Now, the truth is, I have not seen Predator, which I know is a big flaw for a monster fucker, but I just don't know that monster. So I'm not particularly compelled to do a cookie about it. But you know what monster I do know and love? Carnage from Venom. I love her. So much! She's so hot, and I think it'll look great on a cookie. So, yeah. If I could choose by Valentine, it would be Carnage. So I wanted to put it on cookies. And yeah, I've been making progress on piping stuff on cookies. I'm still not great at it. So getting to take the time to stop and practice and make something very detailed, very beautiful would be nice. And it's just sugar cookies and icing. Apart from the time, it's pretty easy. And yeah, so that's the first bake. It's Monday, I will bake the cookie today and ice tomorrow because I'm going to be busy today after that, so I don't have the time, but tomorrow I will be icing it. So yeah, they're my first ones. And the first thing she did was like draw heart shape on a cardboard and cut it out to make a template. I don't need a template. I have two different sizes of heart shaped cookies, cookie cutters. So I will make big ones to decorate and smaller ones to just have like the theme colors in it and to be more. But yeah, I'm going to make just a few big ones. That's all. And the small ones, but there won't be anything very specific detailed on the small ones. They're just going to be adding to the color scheme. So yeah, happy Valentine's Day. Also, I put on my dreads and that pink bow is everything that will have Valentine's Day for today. Tomorrow I'll do better, I'll dress in pink and do something, but yeah, today it's pink bow and that's all. So yeah, I will be making a sugar cookie recipe. It's usually a pretty simple recipe. I have not yet found a sugar cookie recipe that I liked and that worked with gluten-free cookies, flours, but today may be the day that I've been proving wrong. So I'm going to use like half of the rice and corn mix, and a bit less than that in all flour because I have a lot of it. I like the taste of it, which is an improvement compared to all the others. So I think it'll give it a nice taste, and it probably won't change the color, which is good. So I kind of want to do that. So yeah, I'm going to use a bit. I'm not going to use like, it says 5 cups of all-purpose flour, so I'm going to be adding like 3 cups of corn and rice, and then maybe a cup and a half of oat flour because I need to add less oat flour compared to normal wheat flour because it's more dense. So yeah, that's kind of the idea. I'm a little nervous because I really want them to work out, but yeah. Let's do this. It's all in cups because, of course, I miss grams so much. Okay, let's do this. Never mind, I'm going to half that recipe because it's like 5 cups of flour, 1.5 cups of butter, 2 cups of sugar. It's going to be huge. And I don't want to be making like 50 cookies I just want a few ones that I can decorate. I'm not going to make like a dozen heavily decorated big cookies. I'm not insane. So I'm going to half it. And it'll be easier to eat in the end, and it'll be less stress than when I went and make 50 cookies. When in the past I made 50 cookies, it was just one after the other. I didn't have time to put any time in each of them. I ended up sweaty and disgusting and exhausted at the end of it. It's not worth it. So instead I'm going to half it. That means only 3/4 of a cup of butter, which is a lot more realistic already, since already I'm using the small mixer, so I just don't want to do this with like 5 cups of flour. Hell no. So now we're doing that again. Change of plans. Ha! I cannot find my... No, it's not that I can find. I ran out of corn and rice mix, so I'm going to use all oats. Pray. I think I'm going to add a bit of xanthan gum because I just want things to work. And yeah, instead of using 2.5 cups, I'm going to use only 2 cups. It kind of looks like you could use a bit more flour, so kind of want to add a bit more just to make it cozy, you know? The dough is ready, I think. It looks pretty wet, but yeah, it's not bad. I think it just takes a lot of flour not to stick. I think the taste will be nice at least. We'll see how much the oat flour absorbs the water. In a few hours that I spent in the fridge. I would really like it for to be a good recipe that works for me, because I really want to make more cookies that taste good and are easy to work with. I haven't had the best of luck yet on that. Into the fridge. I wrestled my mixer back into submission, and now I have a bunch of hard curd. I got this one, which is the most high quality one, with the bigger one too. But I don't like that the divot there is not super deep, so it doesn't look like a heart as much. Those are better, not as wide, but it's a little better. And I have a bunch of those, and I have this one too, which looks about like this one but in smaller. So I have enough to get by. I'm not too scared about that. The cookie dough is cold, it's firm, it's not hard, it's firm. Put it on parchment paper in layers and refrigerate them for a while before baking them one at a time, because I really don't want them to spread. Like, I know there isn't any any baking powder or anything in there, so it's good, but still I really want it not to spread at all. Happy Valentine's Day, y'all! It is February 14th and I haven't made any progress because I was supposed to do the icing yesterday of the cookies, and that did not happen because yesterday was just a really bad day. It was a, you know, test if I'm not dying from the plague day. And yeah, that did not happen, so all the icing, babe, all the icing have to be done today. So I will have to ask to ice the cookies, make the wings for the bugs tomorrow, and make the decal for the Valentine pie, Valentine's Day pie, later. All of that will be done in royal icing. These are the cookies that I made Monday, so 2 days ago. They turned out so great. They didn't move at all. They didn't rise, they didn't scrape, they didn't move. Maybe it's because I chilled them for like 3 hours, I don't know. But it's amazing. It's my new favorite recipe for cookies. And it tastes pretty damn good. Even without the icing, they're pretty good. I really love the flour, I really love the taste of it, so it's really nice. Big win! I can't wait to decorate them. So let's make some big old batch of icing because I need a lot of it. That's the egg whites that I've been saving from the crème brûlée. So it's still good, no problem. And there's 8 of them. That's gonna make a lot of icing. I have my pile of attachment there because if I'm correct, you're supposed to beat the royal icing but not whip it. If you whip it, it becomes meringue, which is not what I want to do. So to make royal icing, I'm going to actually put everything together and like not beat the egg whites alone. And beat it and not whip it. I'm gonna put a lot of it because experience proved me that it takes a lot of icing sugar, but it's okay, I've got 1 kilogram here, I'm sure it'd be enough. I'm not used to make it in a stand mixer, usually I make it by hand because it's quicker. I don't want to take all my mixer just to make a bit of icing, so I usually don't. And I'm usually, you know, beating it with a spoon, so it doesn't have a lot of impact. So it's quite interesting. I really hope I'm not going to mess up. Because it's a lot of egg whites. I think it's the right consistency. Look at that. It's so thick and beautiful. Still pretty liquidy, but it's okay. I can live with that. Alright, wrap up time. I did all three of my stuff. Look, my bracelet for the last day of Ace Week. I did all of them, and while they did not turn as good and precise and perfect as I would have hoped, they're pretty good for my skill level, and like I'm still learning, and that, you know, I have to account for mistakes and all. This is pretty nice. I'm pretty happy with it. Really happy. So first, I've got my Carnage cookies, and I already sneaked a taste because I've had them for like 2 weeks now, so I already know what they taste like. I've been munching on them since then, but sugar cookies last pretty much forever. They're so good. The oat flour really does it. It's great. Never been much of a fan of the layer of icing on top of cookies, but I always have it with that recipe. Kind of works out. And also, some of them are so cool. I'm so proud of them. I'm just never gonna eat them. I'm going to keep them forever like that, just to be able to tell myself, hey, look, I made that, and they look so cool. The lattice work around the edges, honestly, this is probably the best I could have done. This is far, far less detailed than what she did for the alien cookies. I don't know if she did it. Maybe micro piping tips, maybe different consistency of icing, maybe she left more space on the cookies, maybe then she made bigger cookies and that's why they look smaller. I don't know. I just know that it was not possible with what I had on hand. So this is the best I can do, and it's not that bad. Not super happy with all of my Carnage designs, because I just kind of blob the icing there, telling myself it's a good monster, it's gonna fit. It did not work well, because while it's a good monster, she does have quite a lot of shapes that are very important. But it's okay, I don't mind it too much, and I'm really happy with a lot of what I did. So, alright, see you next week.